Hey guys, welcome back to another video of Creatnprocess. Today we'll be working on text design using the PNG images of green plants component. The component includes flower, leaves, branches. We'll use the wrap tool to wrap this PNG according to our text. And also, we'll understand how to remove the white background using the mask option. We'll add shadows and also do color adjustment using the adjustment layer. So let's begin the tutorial. First of all, I have opened a blank file. I'll just drag in all the PNG images I require for this design. So I got a folder here. Select these. I have selected these images. I'll just click and drag and drop it to Photoshop. So here are all the images on our file. If you check out the layer, here it is, all these images in a smart object. And if your images are not, you make sure you select that layer and convert that into smart object. And once after that, I select all these and I'll just scale this down according to our size. So I'll just selecting everything with a shift and alt press, I'll scale it down and I'll just place it in the center. So let's see, here it is. I'll place it here and enter. Now our images are a smaller size. I'll just hide all these and now let's add our text. So to add a text, I'll just select this text and type out our text. And now let's do the adjustment. So first layer is our this green image. So we'll use this and wrap this up according to the size. So let's select this, Control T. I'll just scale this up a little bit, tilt it a little bit according to it and place it here. And now using the wrap tool, we'll wrap this up according to our design. So right click and wrap. So you got to see that. Now let's do the adjustment. So individually select these point and let's do our adjustment. So here it is, we have used two PNG images and it's almost covered half, and we'll add some details. So to add the details, I'll bring out some images. Okay, this is great. So I'll use this image to add some like branches or root light effect here. So using this, I'll place it on the top. Let's say I'll place it on top for a while and let's work out with it. Like this, and I think we can increase the size a little bit these images. So let's select this one and let's Command T and let's scale its little bit size like that, and I'll just do little adjustment with the wrap. Let's bring this little bit inside because I feel here some kind of emptiness is there, so we have to fill that up using these options. So make sure you do that like that, and this one let's make it a little bit downward. Let's push it a little bit down and let's fill this up and enter. In the same way, I can do some adjustment with this also, Command T. Let's scale this up a little bit. Let's see, and I think it's great. Now let's add a few more details. So let's see, which is okay here. We'll use this for the background a little plants. So I'll just scale this like that, and let's see. Okay, this one we'll place it around here. So Command D and scale it down. Let's see and enter, and I'll bring this layer on the top. Now we need few more PNG images, and this time I got some images which has white backgrounds. So let's drag it inside and let's remove the white background using the mask option. So here is our folder. Let's select those images. So I'll need this. I'll be needing this and this. So let's drag in to Photoshop. Click drag, and here are all the images. We'll just convert this into smart object. All the images, let's convert this into smart object. Now once you have done this, I think this image is already in PNG, so we can just click, drag, and let's drop it to our main file. And let's scale it down. Now let's duplicate this. So I'll just duplicate this one more time. And using the mask option, I'll just hide half of the portion. So selecting this, applying the mask option, let's hide this lower one. Okay, this one. And I'm applying a mask and selecting that mask with a brush tool selected. Let's apply brush stroke at this, and this will be hided. And we got this shape. In the same way, I'll just open this up, other one. And this time we need this piece, and this one should be hidden. So with the mask tool, I'll use the brush again and let's paint it out. And let's zoom it in and place it around here. And I'll place this below this flower like leaves. And let's see the size, Command D, let's increase the size. And we can increase it a little bit more and enter. Okay. Play around with this and you get a nice effect. This one I'll just push this up a little bit and a little bit here. And this one, let's bring this here and let's scale it down, Command D, like this, enter. And let's place it around here. Let's scale down a little bit more, enter. And I see it's looking great, fine. And we'll add one more piece and let's see which image we can use. This one. So we can use this, but here we can see there is a background image white and we have to remove that. So using the same trick, using the mask option, you can easily do that. So we'll use the selection tool and click, not this one, this magic wand tool, and click, select this, and with the alt and backspace, with the color black selected, just up alt and backspace and it will be applied. Now let's click and drag this inside our main file. So here it is. Okay, now let's scale it down a little bit. And I can see there are a few stuff we need to work on here. So with the same tool, let's hide this out. So selecting that and selecting this alt backspace hidden, and let's see more here. We got few stuff, alt backspace, and overall it's great. Let's scale it down and let's see what else we can do. Let's place it in back side. So I'll select this one and place it on the back side here, and I'll just scale this down and I'll just rotate it a little bit and giving some angle here like this, and let's scale it down a little bit more and enter, and here it is. So we got this nice images. Now let's do some detailings here. So we need this, we'll just drag this in, but okay, let's drag this and then work out with that. So I'll just place it here and we're using the same magic wand tool. I'll just select this and with the mask option selected, Command Z, Control D, before that select that layer, apply the mask and then do the selection, and Alt backspace, apply that, and let's hide our few stuff. So and rest, I think it's almost done. So now we can use this, Command D, you can use this, and let's place it in our proper place. So I'll just drag this onto below, on the below layer, and place it around here. Let's scale it down according to our size. So let's scale it down, and let's enter, and let's zoom out a little bit, and I'll just place this around here, and Command T, let's scale this up a little bit, the size, and let's do some rotation. Enter. So here we go, we got this nice sharp grass there, and overall it's great. So next step is to add some shadows. So let's do some shadows. So this one, I'll select this, and below that I need some shadows. So what I'll do is I'll add some shadows here. So below that I'll add a new layer, and with the brush tool selected, let's choose some black color, and I'll do select multiply, reduce the opacity, soft brush, and let's apply some. So here I'm applying some dark color there, like that. Apply some drop shadow there. So you can see that yes, it's working out. That drop shadow is working out. It's giving some depth there. And with the eraser tool, you can just lighten it up a little bit using the opacities. And done. Now, after adding down some shadows, let's do some details. So I'll select everything and Control T, and let's scale it down a little bit and enter, and place it in the center there. And I'll just bring in one more image here, this one. I'll use this for our base to add some more details. So I'll add a mask to this. So we got this, we have removed everything, now it's totally PNG empty. And I'll just click and drag and drop it to our main file. Here it is. And this time I'll place it around here. Let's scale it down and place it in a proper place. Like that, enter, and I'll place it around here. And after that, I'll add some shadow. So to add a shadow, I'll just draw the rectangle here. So clicking rectangle, let's apply some black color, and after that go to filter, blur, Gaussian blur, and just apply. After all, we have to add few more stuff, like we need to add some like hanging branches a little bit. So we'll use the brush tool to draw it out. So I'll just draw out using the brush tool. So I'll add a new layer, let's say anywhere. So I'll add it around here, and using the brush tool selected, I'll pick up a color. So with the eye picker, I'll select this this color, and brush tool, make it thin, let's make it sharp one. Okay, and I'll just make it thin, and let's draw. So like this, and after that I'll just apply some overlay color. Let's apply some overlay, and I'll choose a color from here. Let's say a dark one, maybe I'll choose some just a little bit lighter one from here, maybe from there. Okay, and I'll apply some inner shadow. And selecting that, I'll reduce the distance. Okay, and let's see, check it out. I think it's giving some effect there. I'll just change the color to something else, like this darker tone, and let's apply. So let's zoom it out and let's check out how it's looking. And I think it's looking great, it's looking natural. And we have used the brush tool and draw it out this. Now let's do some color adjustments. So to do that, I'll just add some adjustment layers. So first I'll use the brightness and contrast, and here let's increase the brightness a little bit, and let's do some adjustments there. Okay, and there, and liking. And after that I'll apply some do some color changes. So I use the hue and saturation, and let's change it to and increase the hue saturation value a little bit, and shift it a little bit, like yellowish color tone. This time here we have green, so just increase it to a little bit yellowish color tone, giving it some fresh color. And let's do some adjustment with the brightness and contrast. So here we go, using the brightness and contrast, we'll bring out that effect like that, and I'll just increase the contrast value and decrease the, maybe like keeping this up. So let's see, it's very dark, dense and fresh color overall, this one. Let's see. And if I had this out, you can see the effect there changes. And so this is our green design. We have used PNG images, and we have learned how to remove the background images using mask option, and also applied wrap tool in a very nice way. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up. And if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.